Diabetics are 2 to 4 times more likely to develop cardiovascular disease than others. This is huge, guys. Cardiovascular disease is basically diseases of the heart and of the blood vessels, but that's not it. This is the thing. Most people with type 2 diabetes will eventually develop cardiovascular disease, and cardiovascular disease is the most common cause of death in people with diabetes. This is why we are talking about this. And to give you an example of some of these cardiovascular diseases, I'm going to give you others, but people with diabetes are 2 times more likely to have heart disease or a stroke. That's just a quick example. You know, this is a real talk, okay? If you have diabetes, or if you're at risk for diabetes with prediabetes, etc., this is especially for you. I need you to listen up and understand some of your risks so that you can do what you can, and there are things to do to help lower your risk of cardiovascular diseases. Guys, I'm Dr. Jen Caudle, practicing family physician. Let's just jump right in, okay? What kind of cardiovascular diseases am I talking about? Well, let's talk about heart disease in particular, okay? That is when blood circulating the heart is slowed or stopped due to blocked arteries. We oftentimes think of things like chest pains or heart attacks when we talk about heart disease in particular. But this is sort of a component of cardiovascular disease in general that I'm talking about, that you are at higher risk for if you are a diabetic. Also, there's an increase of risk of stroke. Remember, a stroke basically is when you have decreased blood flow in blood vessels to the brain. Blood vessels and blood flow is blocked to the brain. Sounds very similar to that with heart disease, right? Or a heart attack, right? It is very similar. Your risk for that is higher as well. That's under the category of cardiovascular disease. Also, you have an increased risk of what we call peripheral vascular disease. That is blockages in arteries that are towards your extremities, your feet, your legs, and things like that. That is big, by the way. And again, all of these are sort of under the umbrella of cardiovascular disease. Diabetics are also more likely to have heart failure. That is when the heart does not pump the way it is supposed to. These are just some examples of cardiovascular diseases. Again, diseases that affect the heart and the blood vessels. But understand, being a diabetic increases your risk for cardiovascular disease in general just by virtue of being a diabetic, okay? So you probably are saying, well, gosh, thanks for the good news, Dr. Jen. And I know it's tough to hear this, but it's really important that you know this so that you do a few things, very important things, to help lower your risk of progressing to heart disease and having problems. And that's something I really want to focus on here. There are things you can do to lower this risk, okay? First thing is, you got to see your doctor regularly. If you're a type 2 diabetic, honestly, I was just in the office a couple of days ago, and I saw some patients that, even though we've talked about the importance of being seen for regular intervals, they're not coming in regularly. You've got to come, or rather go, to see your doctor at regular intervals, not only to have your blood sugar checked, but to make sure you're having other checks, your eyes checked, your feet checked, your heart if need be. There are plenty of things to do. So if your doctor tells you as a diabetic to come in every 3 months or 4 months or 6 months or whatever, please make sure that you're doing it, because there's a reason why we need you to come in so much. There are things we need to be doing. Some of that is to lower your risk of developing cardiovascular disease, okay? The other thing is, other things to lower your risk of developing these cardiovascular issues, the stroke, the peripheral vascular disease, heart failure, etc., that I talked about. Things like, if you smoke, quit smoking. If you don't smoke, don't start, okay? Lose weight. And I shouldn't say lose weight. Rather, what I should say is keep a healthy weight, okay? Some of you may not need to lose weight, but keeping a healthy weight is going to be important. Talk with your doctor about what weight is the ideal weight for you. Eat a healthy diet, guys. The fried foods, fatty foods, there's plenty of other foods that are not great. Carbohydrate-laden foods, definitely not the best over the long haul and the long term, okay? You need to eat a healthy diet, very important. Exercising does so much good. It does so much good for so many different things. Please exercise. And then the other thing kind of falls into the category of making sure you're seeing your doctor regularly is keeping a healthy blood pressure, healthy cholesterol levels, healthy blood sugar levels. All of those things will help lower your risk of cardiovascular disease as a diabetic. And honestly, because being a diabetic, your risk for cardiovascular disease is so much higher than the general populations, you got to really, really stay on this. I don't know, if I don't sound like a family doc now, I don't know what I sound like. I feel like I'm literally talking to a patient in my office. It's just just that I care and I want you to be as healthy as possible. So work with us, work with your doctor, not that you're not working with us, but meaning partner with your doctor to really sort of achieve these goals, which I know you can do. Guys, spread this video on to other people who could benefit from it. The idea is to get the word out and keep us all healthy. I'm Dr. Jen Caudle, practicing family physician, on-air health expert, and video creator. If you've not liked and followed my page, I invite you to do so. For those of you who send stars, I respond to you personally. And consider joining my subscription group called Dr. Jen Superstars. And for those of you on YouTube, hello, please subscribe to my channel and click the little bell for updates. Guys, I'm Dr. Jen. I'll see you soon.